Bloody duck! Alright, Bert, it's the Horwood Moon Marathons, isn't it?
Have a look, have a ganders.
How you doing, people? Are you well?
I thought you were.
So I'm off in my van with the bat bike in the back to go and do a motorcycle endurance event. I'll tell you all the details of the event when I get there, but all you need to know at the moment is it's the Horwood Moon Marathon and it's run by Rally Duck. That probably brings out two questions. One, what's the Horwood Moon Marathon? And two, who are Rally Duck? So Rally Duck is both a community and business that is run by my good friend, Allard Morgan. Allard himself, and not that he'd tell you this, but he's a very established rally rider. He's won events in the UK. He rode for AJP as their factory rider in the Hellas Rally in Greece. And he started Rally Duck to bring people together through rally. And he also does instruction where he teaches people one-to-one. And he's taught me, and he's pretty good. Rally Duck is growing massively. To put it into perspective, this year, he sponsored a British rider in the Dakar. I've also got a vested interest. I helped Alan set up Rally Duck when it first started. I made the logo. That's about it, but I still feel like I did something. It's not just me in the van at the moment, because I'm gonna be doing a lot of filming, and for those of you that have filmed, you'll know it can be a bit of a pain in the ass. I've brought along my good friend Jonesy, who is basically here to be my bitch. He's gonna be filming, cooking, looking after me and giving me cuddles when I get tired and emotional. But we've got a long way to go right now. We've got to get to Wales. We've got just under 3 hours left. We've already been driving for an hour and a bit. So we'll chat to you when we get there.
It's my colour.
What did that have for you?
That's a lovely t-shirt you've got there, sir.
This is Jonesy. Jonesy.
Hey, Alan, how's it going, dude?
Laura. Hey, good. How are you?
Your signs are the wrong way, mate. The signs send you over there.
I know. I'm well aware.
So Horwood Moon Marathon is a 60-hour, potentially 60-hour endurance event. And the way it works is we've got five loops to do. Each of them can take up to 12 hours. You need to have finished a loop and be starting the next one in the next 12 hours or you're cancelled. So the way it works is the route's given to you on a GPX file, so I've stuck it on my Montana. And basically we've got to follow the line. And you might think, oh, that's easy. But like I said, we're going to be riding for up to 60 hours. So we're going to be knackered. The route is a lot of road, but mostly off-road here in Wales, which can be quite tricky. If I finish one lap, I'll be happy. If I finish three, I'll be really happy. If I finish five, then something weird has happened because I'm not expecting to get that far. The event was being held in Wales, which, as I said, is a bit of a trek from the south coast, and was based in a Welsh town that I pronounce incorrectly as Llanidloes.
It's Llanidloes, mate, not Llanidloes.
Huh? Lap 1 and 2 were around 230 miles apiece. Lap 3, the Joker lap, was around 200 miles and looked like Allard had gone mad with a crayon. And then 4 and 5 were 1 and 2 in reverse. Simples.
So if you're thinking of doing this event, you can do it on any bike, really. I'm doing it on the back bike, my big, heavy KTM 990, which might be emotional. But when we walk around, you'll see that people are here on enduro bikes. So there's a 350 here, there's a 450 here, all sorts of bikes. There's a big GS around the corner. You can do it on whatever you like. But you need to do a bit of bike prep. I've got all the tools so I can fix it on the trail, so punch repair kits, anything to take it apart, strip it down. I've got a little first aid kit at the back, and then yeah, I've just got food, nutrition, a bit of water. Off we go, it should be fine.
And because I'm a posh git, I've got an absolutely mega setup.
Well, first of all, thank you for all making the effort. You're either brave enough or stupid enough. I'm not quite sure which one, really. Obviously, you've all got the routes now. There's nothing gnarly. There's nothing showstoppers. The aim of it is for you to come back and go, there were some parts where I pushed myself a little bit harder than I thought, but I had a really good time, okay? The only thing I'm marking you on is your time and your distance. So I'll be resetting your trips on the start. As long as you are over the distance, I don't really mind. If you come back and you've done 100 miles, then you probably cheated a little bit, okay?
Just had the riders briefing. I've clocked this, and don't tell anyone, but because I left my Rally Duck fleece at home because I forgot it, my jersey, I'm just going to steal it. Jonesy, quick, go.
Good luck.
Good luck, behold. Take it easy.
Don't touch me, you might have COVID.
Oh God. What have we let ourselves in for? Right, I've got 8 minutes till I start, so time to get the bike on. Fingers crossed this starts. Right, while you're pissing, I'm going to talk to you. So tell the camera what we've just decided.
We're going to ride together.
We're going to ride together because Seats feel sorry for me because I keep falling over. You know when you said to me, Ollie, bring your 350, and I went, nah.
What are you thinking now, Ollie?
I'm on the fence. Do you reckon with us now we could just paddle it along?
You could try it. My worry is that with the if you get a tyre stuck on that,
yeah, it'll go down.
This is like,
yeah. See, it's what you're doing.
What I'm doing is wasting my time.
let me show the camera that knife.
That's not a knife.
This is a knife.
This is a sword.
Still a shit one though.
Tell me you've got a proper fold-out saw. If you've got a bigger dick than this guy, then this is going to be excellent, because mine's the smallest. Wee, 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 this is a little one. Oh, yours is actually cutting.
I reckon I've got the same size dick as him, unfortunately.
Fucking hell, this wasn't in the this wasn't in the job description, was it?
I've got a serrated saw in the van.
Oh, that's helpful. That's really helpful.
Yeah,
I've got a serrated saw in the garage at home.
Yeah, well, there we go, isn't it? Yeah.
I've got my helmet on, mate. Do you want me to go next? Fuck it up. Yeah, I'll go as a water. Made a meal of that, didn't we? Yeah, easy. Oh, we'll do that. Easy. Go.
Wait.
Back
a little bit. Go.
Well done, team.
Well, he shit himself.
Time for an energy gel. I am knackered. I'm popping my cherry. Bodge tape has come together. And we're gonna ride together. This is a big ask. This is a mighty challenge. Look at this.
Al's being sociable, look at this, yeah. Stuff in my face.
Tech now.
I've no idea how to work this thing. Everyone knows that, already. Baby, I got you.
Oh,
make no mistake, this has been awesome fun.
Hi!
Seems we've bumped into the cameraman. Let's have a little chat. So I reckon we're about just under halfway, you reckon?
168, 206, yeah, just under.
Yeah, just under halfway. It's been pretty good. It's been pretty hard. Our next planned stop is the fuel station, which is in about 10 miles, I think. Fuel up and then carry on, because I think we're gonna struggle to get back in time now. So yeah. We need to get a move on.
Might time out, but yeah. Hey, we'll do the lap.
Whee! Be like when we did the hard Alpie and we just disregarded
just
the time.
Just disregard the rules.
Did what we want. But yeah, short and sweet. See you soon.
See ya.
Al's bike's had a weird electrical fault where it keeps trying to start itself. You can have the key off, the kill switch off, and it just turns over the starter. Da-da-da-da-da-da. That seems to have gone away and seems to be linked to water, but his bike's just cut out. Whatever that fault was, I think, has got a bit worse, and it just completely died as we were going along the road. So I'm gonna have a look, try and fix it, and see where to go from there.
So do you remember what I said to you about the brittle cables I've noticed?
Yeah, I know.
That was these, and that's why I amalgied it all up.
Oh, right.
Just to try and it's proper melted, isn't it?
Yeah, it's fucked.
Oh, fucking hell.
We found the problem. It's a wiring fault that is not fixable. So this guy is gonna have to be collected.
For me, Zivor is over.
Zivor? Don't mention Zivor.
Hey Alan. Can your bike do this?
Fuck! Just come to the infamous hill. Yeah, it's right near the end. We might be within our 12 hours if we get up here, right?
Yeah.
But it gets really steep. Hopefully the camera shows it. But I'm going to turn this off to save battery, and you'll see when we get up there.
When we get up there tomorrow.
Feels like we're about to go over the top, doesn't it? Hey, get on.
I really must get this starter motor sorted. We got there eventually. You can edit that out.
No. Oh no. You see what happened?
No. Okay, so this isn't working. Seats is just coming down. We'll see how this goes.
We tried.
Well, we can turn it around.
This was the result. The back wheel just won't get any traction up here.
It was fun to watch him try though.
If I meet you here?
Yeah, yeah.
So if I
meet you at that junction, yep.
Rock-a-bye, baby.
Here's your orange sherbet.
Well, that was emotional. So we ended up getting in at 12 hours and 5 minutes, so just over the timing. However, there's been a lot of carnage, so a couple of people have injured themselves. One of the bikes broke down, as you saw, Al's bike, and actually only two people out of all the people that started have got out on the night loop on time. So because of all of that, and because of the fact we stopped a few times to help people out, Alan's given us about an hour flex just to sort ourselves out. Seeks and I are having a quick turnaround, and then we're gonna get straight back out to do the night lap. We need to do some repairs. My electrics on my bike have stopped working, so I'm just, as you can see, I've got a set of crimps, so we're just gonna fix that and then get back on the road. My Montana stopped working, which then shorted the lights, so they stopped working, which was handy in the dark. And also my heated grips have stopped working, so it's all kicking off. That in there, let's get that in there. Let's do a quick test. There we go, working. Fixed. Oh no. How's the event going for you, mate?
Marvellous. Everyone's enjoying themselves. Well, they're putting on a happy face.
Yeah, we're pretending to enjoy ourselves. Yeah.
If you tell yourself enough times, I'm having a great time. How's your event going, Mr. Nice?
Good. All good. So we've been given half an hour extra by Allard. I'm getting some of this down me. And then we'll hit the road, Jack. Yep. We're having a great time, Allard. A great time.
Who's Jack?
I don't know, but he's always hitting the road. We've gained one. We've got Quinny. Say hello, mate.
Hello, mate.
His riding buddy is one of the guys that got injured, so Quinny's going to jump on with us, and then we're going to go and tackle a bit of night riding.
Fun times.
Back with your push.
We just take 2 seconds.
Huh?
I blow in.
I'm not in a good place right now. It's 3:30 in the morning and I am completely burnt out. I've fallen off this bike, I don't know, about 10 times in the last 10 minutes. Me, Quinny and Seats has stopped and decided, all right, enough's enough. We'll get to the end of this trail and we'll go home. And I mean, this is one of the most technical trails we've done for it being slippy and us being tired anyway. I went to start my bike and the battery's completely dead. And we are in the middle of the trail, in the middle of nowhere. There's no way to bump start this where we are. I'm in a whole world of hurt right now, if I'm honest. All right, I'll speak to you soon. So we've come up with a plan. 2K back down this track, there is like a turn off. And then about another 2K, there's a farm that's on a little road. So Seats and Quinny have just ridden down that way, and the plan is to stop there, take the battery out of Quinny's 990, Seats will ride it back to me, stick it in the back bike, and Allard is on his way as well in his van. Hopefully this will all work out, that once I get down there, Allard will be there. I can put the 990 in the van and call it quits. As you can tell, I'm a little bit perkier than earlier, because we've got a plan and I've just eaten a load of chocolate. Let's get this dead battery out. Look, there you go, look, press the button, dead. Ready for when Seats gets back in God knows how long. And then we'll fit Quinny's. Hiya.
Temperatures.
Made it! It's time to go home.
I can be your hero, baby.
I can't kiss away the pain though.
YMCA, go on. That's it. D-I-S-C-O.
I don't know if I can do that one.
The rescue, mate, that was fucking wicked. Had the showers crossed.
Smelly for a bit there.
Go for about 15,000 wet wipes, I think.
Wipe my bum again.
Yeah.
are you going to go back up?
I don't know, because I don't know if this is any fit state to it yet. I need to have a quick once over and have a look. See how I feel when I wake up. Morning, people. It's now 11 o'clock and I've had about 3 hours sleep. So yeah, last night, ironically, the trail that we got stuck on was called Happy Valley or Happy Trail or Happy something. I wasn't very happy last night. I was pretty tired. So to summarize what's gone on then, so the two people who started lap two didn't finish. Nobody has finished. So where am I? I've had a look around the bike. Basically, long story short, the battery's knackered. I don't think it's charging properly. We're gonna jump this bike in a minute. If the battery's charging, we'll test on the multimeter, leave it running. And then today, what most people are doing is lap three, which was known as a joker lap, but just as a fun ride. The poor back bike took a bit of a beating yesterday. So let's list the things. So the exhaust has got a nice big dent in it. The bark buster guards have got a nice big chip where they've taken a rock, as have a lot of the graphics and the paint. And the gear lever is bent, meaning that I can't downshift, I can't select down because it physically hits the side stand now. One thing to point out as well is both my tyres are knackered, and I knew that before I came to this event, but I'm looking to get new wheels soon. I didn't want to get new tyres because the new wheels are going to be a different profile. I paid the price for that last night because it was a lot of hard work. So what's going to happen today, if I can get the bike working, Alan, because his bike's broken, is very kindly lent me his rear tyre and his gear lever, so we're going to fit that and then head out into the Welsh hills on this beautiful sunny day. One, two, three, jump! So we're ready, bike's all good. Quinny's bike's all good. Seats has been all good all morning and just annoying everyone. And we're gonna go do lap three, which is the Joker, or bit of lap three, and then get back here in time to just have a nice chilled night, a couple of beers, barbecue, and chillax. Job jobbed.
Oh no, the 990 strikes again.
Hey Quinny,
welcome to Bodge Tape Adventures.
This is your fault, mate. My bike was running sweet until you borrowed my battery. It was perfect, like. Thank you, anyway.
Good honour, remember. We'll send you a shit certificate in the post.
Yeah. Isn't the normal Bodge Tape thing just to fucking ditch him?
Yeah, normally.
See ya.
Ladies and gentlemen, can I please have your attention? I've just been handed an urgent and horrifying news story. And I need all of you to stop what you're doing and listen.
So Ollie, how are you getting on?
Morning mate. Very well, very well. Today is pack up day after a pleasant evening. We had a few beers, a few whiskies and a few cigars, which was lovely. So yeah, most people have packed up or are packing up and they're getting ready to go. It's Monday, no one else is riding. Riding has stopped, today is just travel home day. But before I can go home, I need to give Alan back all of his stuff that he lent me, like this wheel and the lever. The bike's done really well. I'm pretty impressed. Well, I'm always impressed by this thing. It needs a bit of love when I get home. It's missing a few bolts out of this side, and there's dents, scratches, bruises on that and me. But it's been good. You enjoyed yourself, mate?
Yeah, absolutely.
Yeah?
Welsh weather.
Yeah, this. What's this all about?
It's a treat.
It was supposed to be raining. We're in Wales. Right, I need to get on with this because we're on some sort of time now, aren't we, to get on the road? So, I'll speak to you in a bit.
It's good, eh? Take care, mate.
And there you go, that's basically it. What can I say about it? Sum it up really quickly. It's definitely challenging. Maybe a little bit too challenging this time, but next time I think it will be tweaked to make it a bit more manageable. The trails were absolutely epic. Some of the best riding I've done. And I definitely found my limit. So if that seems like something that you'd like to do, make sure you get along to the next one. We'll see you next time.
Lally duck.
So obviously, I always said that the Sprocket Spirit Award, so to speak, would be not going to the winner, but going to the person I felt that kind of committed to the cause the most and kind of went like a bit of above and beyond and just enjoyed it all the way through, didn't really grumble and all that. So with that in mind, I feel it's going to the person that even took their bike apart so that to get someone off a mountain. So, Quinny.
Yes!
Speech!
That's going to be emotional getting it on the bike.
Ollie Moto.